This is Teresa Adams, and what we're going to be doing now is we're going to be doing the second example for graphing polynomial functions. So my second example is going to be x minus 2 squared, x plus 1, and multiplied by x minus 1. When I'm graphing my polynomial functions, the first thing I need to know is what the degree of my polynomial is so that I can find my end behavior. Again, the end behavior is as the graph approaches negative infinity and positive infinity, what's going to happen to the ends of it. So what I want to do is I want to find the degree. The way in which I find the degree is either I can multiply all these out, or I can just pull off the fact that I know if I were to multiply this first term out, I would end up with an x squared term. If I were to then multiply it by this, I'd pick up another x term, and if I were to multiply it by this, I would get another x term. So I'd end up with x to the fourth. So my degree of a polynomial, or n, is 4. The next thing I need to know before I do my n behavior is I need to know what my leading coefficient is, or my an. So as I look at this, I have a 1 here, so that's my coefficient starting out with. The coefficient on this x has to also happen to be a 1. And this x, all each have coefficients of 1. So my leading coefficient, when I multiply it all out, is going to be 1. So my an is 1. That happens to be greater than 0. So now that I know what my leading coefficient is and I know what my degree is, I know what my end behavior is. As I approach negative infinity, it's going to come up to positive infinity. As I approach a positive infinity, it will be positive infinity as well. The next thing I'm going to do after I find out what my end behavior is the max number of turns. To find the max number of turns is I take the degree, or n, and subtract 1 from it. So I have 4 minus 1, which is 3. So I have, at the most, 3 turns. I'm not guaranteed 3 turns, but I know I won't have more than 3 turns. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to find my y-intercept. The way in which I find my y-intercept is I put in 0 for x. So f of 0 is equal to 0 minus 2 squared, and 0 plus 1, and then 0 minus 1. So this ends up being a negative 2 squared, so that's 4, then 1, and then negative 1. So I get negative 4. So my y-intercept will be 0, negative 4. Our next step is to find the x-intercepts, or the zeros of the polynomials. The way in which we do that is we take each one of our factors and set them to 0. So I have x minus 2 is equal to 0, x plus 1 is equal to 0, and x minus 1 is equal to 0. And you're thinking, wait a minute, it's x minus 2 squared. All right, so we can do that as x minus 2 squared. But I need to get rid of that squared. So the way in which I get rid of that squared is I take the square root of both sides. So I have x minus 2 is equal to, and the square root of 0 is just 0. So I could have just wrote it as x minus 2 and not worried about the squared. And the same thing is true if it's a cubed or to the fourth or anything like that. So I get x is equal to 2, x is equal to negative 1, and x is equal to 1. So my intercepts are at 2, 0, negative 1, 0, and at 1, 0. Now I need to figure out at those if I'm going to bounce or pass. So I need to look at the multiplicity or the degree of each one of my factors. The degree of this factor is 2. If the degree is even, then I bounce. So at this one, I'm going to bounce. My next one, the degree of this, or the power on that one, is a 1. And then if the power is odd, then I pass through. And then my next one, I look at this one, and it also has a degree 1, so I pass through this one as well. Step 5 should confirm all of this. So on step 5, what I want to do is I want to figure out what the behavior is as I approach each one of these. So I'm going to do x is equal to 2. So I have f of 2. Now when I do this, I'm going to put 2, but I'm not going to put it into this first one. Because if I put 2 into this first one, it's going to give me 0, and that's not going to be helpful. So I'm going to write it as x minus 2 squared, and then wherever all the other places I see x, I put 2 in there. So I have 2 plus 1, and 2 minus 1. So this gives me 3, this gives me 1, so I have 3 times x minus 2 squared. And this confirms that I have a bounce, because I know this happens to be a quadratic, and the shape of a quadratic looks something like this. And that confirms that I'm going to touch that and bounce back off. Now I'm going to do x is equal to negative 1. F of negative 1 is equal to, I have negative 1 minus 2 squared. I don't put negative 1 there, so I leave it as x plus 1. And in the last one, I have negative 1 minus 1. So this gives me negative 3 squared, which is 9, times a negative 2. So it's a negative 18 x plus 1. This means I have a linear equation with a slope of a negative 18. So it's going to look something like that. Lastly, I'm going to put in as x is equal to 1. So I have f of 1 is equal to 1 minus 2 squared, 1 plus 1, and then x minus 1. So this gives me 1 minus 2 is a negative 1 squared, which is 1, times 2. So I have 2 times x minus 1. What this means is I have a linear equation with a slope of a positive 2, and so it should look something like that. Now what we're going to do is we're going to pull together steps 1 through 5 so we can sketch a graph of this polynomial function. So based on step number 1, I know that I have a degree 4, the leading coefficient is 1, so I know the end behavior is going to be positive infinity both this tail and at this tail. Based on step number 2, and I'm going to have at most 3 turns. The next thing I'm going to do is write down my y-intercept. My y-intercept for this one was negative 4. So I know that my graph has to go through that negative 4. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to look at step number 4. Step number 4 gave us the x-intercepts of negative 1, 1, and 2. So I know I'm either going to touch those or I'm going to bounce through those. So I'm going to start from my left and I'm going to work my way right. So I'm going to go to, starting from my left, go to negative 1. At negative 1, based on step 4 and 5, I know I'm going to go to that 0 and I'm going to pass through it. So then I'm going to come back down, I'm going to go down to my y-intercept. I'm going to go through my y-intercept because I need to. And then at number 1 here, based on steps 4 and 5, I know I'm going to pass through that too. So I'm going to go through that. And I need to come back down and I need to go back to my next 0. My next 0 is 2. Now remember, from steps 4 and 5, I know I'm going to touch that intercept and I'm going to bounce back off because the multiplicity happens to be 2. So I'm going to come down to it and have that quadratic shape and it's going to look like that. So there's a graph of my polynomial. I have the x-intercepts or the zeros at negative 1, 1, and 2. Multiplicity of 1s here, so they're even or odd and they go through. And a multiplicity of 2 here based on that, so I touch it and bounce back off, and again, my y-intercept. So everything matches up, so I must have done everything right.